What is happening, everybody? My name is Brian. Welcome to your sub 3 hour marathon training plan introduction video. I got a lot of messages on Instagram, The Pace Pusher, asking about how do I get to sub 3 hour marathon. So I wanted to put together a 16 week marathon training program that I personally use that got me to my first sub 3 hour marathon. I did it in 2017. My first sub 3 hour marathon was a 2:54 at the New York City Marathon. If you know anything about that race, it is a difficult race. So for this plan to get me to a sub 3 hour, I am confident if you follow it week by week, hit the pacing, hit the quality workouts, you too can hit a sub 3 hour marathon. So want to jump into one key attribute that has helped me in my sub 3 hour marathon training journey, and that is Wahoo running. So for me, it is really important to be able to have a community of people that back you in what you are doing. And so for me, that's Wahoo running. It's an online running community that really helps with team building, strength routines, support and accountability, not to mention the friendships that I built through Wahoo Running. Carly and Christy, who are the main head coaches for Wahoo Running, have built an awesome community around the country that helps with accountability, questions, and different things like that. And so for me, making sure you're a part of some type of community is really important, and for me, that's Wahoo Running. And so the other thing that I really genuinely like about Wahoo Running is not only do they have a online community and do they have a great presence online, but they don't take running too serious. At the end of the day, running is supposed to be our outlet. Running is our hobby. Running is something that brings us to our friends and brings us, you know, some fulfillment in life. And it's not our life. Running is meant to be an asset that helps drive it. And that is one thing that Carly and Christy really bring in. And that's why they call it Wahoo. Too many people are standing at the start line and they stand there and they'll yell out Wahoo at the starting line because it's meant to be fun and it's meant to be enjoyable. So make sure you check out Wahoo Running. For me, it's super valuable to be part of my running journey. And so I hope that you take a look at them. Check out their online running crew. Now let's jump right into this 16-week plan. So two key things that we're going to talk about is your pacing and your base training. Number one, let's talk about base training. This plan is made to be built for those that are running 30 to 40 miles a week going into it, because starting week one, you're running just under 40 miles a week. And so it's really important to be able to do a bunch of easy runs to accumulate within 2 months before to hit that 40 miles a week. And so for month one, what you should be doing is making sure you're getting yourselves up to 25 to 35 miles a week. And then in month two, making sure you hit at the end of month two, being able to hit 35 to 40 miles a week. That's critically important because you don't want to go from doing nothing to jumping into 40 miles a week. It's a really difficult task. And so make sure that you are hitting that base training. If you have any questions, Wahoo has a great base training program on their crew online, so make sure you check that out. It's super easy to download, be able to put into whether it be your VDOT or whether you just want to use a PDF calendar. It's really simple to be able to utilize that, so definitely take a look at that base training because it's worked out really well. Second, let's dive into pacing. So in order to hit a 3 hour marathon, you need to be able to run 6:51s for the duration of the marathon. So we've broken out easy pacing, marathon pacing, tempo or threshold pacing, interval pacing, and repetition. These are the ways that we'll break out these workouts. So you'll see E for easy, M for marathon, T for tempo or threshold, I for interval, R for repeat. Really self-explanatory. So here is how those pacings break out. For your easy pace, it is a big range. The goal is to make sure your heart rate is low. So that range is 7:45 all the way up to 9 minutes. Really make sure you're taking those workouts easy. Make sure your heart rate is low because you want yourself to be ready for the quality sessions that are in the following paces. For your marathon pacings, real simple, 6:52 to 6:51. It is a narrow range because when we're working marathon pacing, we want to make sure we hit those numbers. Into tempo or threshold, it is quicker. It's about your half marathon pace. It's 6:30 to 6:25. So making sure you have that little range in there. That is the area that will help for your tempo and your threshold runs, or what we call half marathon pace sometimes. Your next pace is your interval. So when we're doing longer repeats, sometimes miles, 2Ks, 3Ks, we really want to focus in this interval section. That pacing is 605 to 558 per mile. Making sure that we're in that range is really important because, again, these are for your quality sessions. And then when we get into track Tuesdays or your track or shorter interval workouts, that is going to be 535 to your 530 pace. So making sure you're in that 530 to 535 pace is really what's going to help you out. If you have any questions, your pacings will also be on the PDF, as well as they will be down below for you to take a look at. If you have any questions, always refer back to this intro video. As we work through weeks 1 through 16, it's going to be talking about a lot of these different pacings, so make sure you follow it up. Go check out Wahoo, make sure you hit subscribe, and I really look forward to jumping on this 3-hour marathon journey with you together. Have a great day. See you on week 1.